restraints off. Your judgment has waited long enough.
Just get it over with.
Worked out pretty well. Or maybe not.
Lady, I haven't got all day. You want to be rescued or not?
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the 13th mission of my Halo Wars Legendary Walk the Guide. This is Beachhead. This mission is probably one that's going to give you guys a lot of issues. This one's very, very difficult early on. Lots of difficulty with just how many Marines you're given. Clearing out the Covenant base that we're going to see in the very beginning is extremely difficult. It takes a lot of time to actually clear the base. But I'm going to show you guys the easiest way to do that. A lot of this part, you can take your time. I'm not going to... The strategy that I want to be using is going to be one that has a lot of success. The first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to send these Marines, of course, away from the Flood that are attacking. You don't want to lose any of your troops. If you do lose any, feel free to restart. It's very, very important that you don't lose any of your guys. You have plenty of supplies starting out this mission. A lot of the area that we're about to go into, there's going to be some supplies. We're going to go grab those first. So use the, if you're on Xbox, you can send your troops kind of by microing them into certain areas. You're going to send Forge to go gather the right side. The Marines plus the Flamethrower are going to go clear out the left side. Make sure you use your RPGs or your special abilities to clear out this turret right here. And then go grab the supplies right here. Forge, on the other hand, he's going to be sitting here kind of chilling, going to grab those supplies. There is another wave of attacks coming in up onto the left side. Make sure you clear those out as well. As we've done previously in this entire guide, if you are getting your troops, if they're taking a little too much fire, feel free to micro them away. Typically, the enemy will stop attacking you if you send the target that they're actually firing at away, and they'll just change targets. Forge right here, he's going to be taking a little bit of the Jackal fire. We're going to keep those Marines and everybody over there for a little bit. The Jackals will come up here. And then you're going to use... I would recommend, of course, using the Forge special ability as well. Most of the troops you have are ODSTs, but remember, medics only heal who are currently in their squad. They don't create any new troops, so you want to make sure that you are using heal and repair here. Of all the supplies that we just gathered, heal and repair kind of paid for itself. So we're going to send all of our troops up, and we're going to try to keep as left as possible. We don't want to get the Locust or the Wraith targeting our Marines, our Flamethrower, or Forge. We're going to get three Spartans here as soon as Anders gets picked up. As she gets picked up, Spartans come on down. There they are. Now, the Spartans are a very big part of the strategy that I employ. For an example, like, I keep Jerome, I believe. I keep Jerome in the back, and he just snipes the turrets. That's his job. Douglas, I think I think I actually got it mixed up. We'll see right here. I send Douglas to go hijack the Locust. I send Alice to go hijack the Wraith. And Jerome here, he's going to be targeting the turrets right here. So I was right initially. Once you have everybody aggroed on your Spartans, you want to send in Forge, your Marines, and those flamethrowers. You want to make sure that none of your forces get... you want to make sure that none of the Spartans get killed, so to speak. You want to make sure that the Locust gets out fairly easily. The Wraith can chill up front because it is a tank. Its entire function is to take damage. And the Locust, you will want to make sure that it's attacking the turrets as well. Once you clear out the very like front two turrets on that Covenant base, you're going to want to start... You're going to want to start targeting the Covenant base and sending those ODSTs away from them. We need all the troops that we can get for this beginning part. Losing any of them is extremely bad. At 50% of any Covenant base throughout this mission, they will send Honor Guards at you. You will want to make sure that you target down those Honor Guards and make sure that your forces don't get... none of your Spartans get killed. So make sure that you... If your forces are getting a little too... are getting a little bit of... Like, they're taking a little too much fire, you want to micro them away. Jerome is very, very good against anti-infantry. He is an anti-infantry Spartan, so make sure that you... You kind of keep that in mind when you're facing these Honor Guards. That's actually a huge reason why I wanted him to stay out of these vehicles. He's really, really good at making sure that the enemies get killed fairly quickly, and his range is overpowered. Even those turrets at the very front here won't be able to target Jerome. Make sure you use heal and repair whenever you need to. Don't ever feel like you have to be conservative with heal and repair. You want to make sure you use heal and repair as much as possible. Alright. So the Jackals will be consistent. They will always keep attacking your base. Once you build this base, you are sending... You basically get the... it's not the fun part of the mission, I'll tell you that. You're going to get a bunch of Banshees that are going to absolutely just make your life... awful. They will consistently target down your turrets, and you're just gonna have to keep rebuilding them throughout the entire time of this mission. But once you destroy the all the summits around the map, they'll stop coming. Anyways, once you get your station up, you're gonna want to put all these... there's a certain way you want to structure how your forces are out. I don't actually go out and attack right away, like I have in pretty much a majority of all the other videos. I just kind of make sure that we get everything set up first. Of course, we're going to get our supply pads up first before we get our reactor. That way, we're at least getting some sort of income. We're going to move Jerome up. We're going to make sure that the turrets also get built as soon as possible. And then we're going to move all of our troops to the... what would be the southwest turret, the one where all of them are at currently. You're going to make sure that all those forces are right there. Jerome is going to stay towards the front of the base because there's going to be troops that also attack. Like, as you see here, this is that first attack that I'm talking about from those Banshees. Make sure that you use your RPG whenever you can. Upgrade a fortress. That also gives you extra health on your base, extra armor. But yeah, they'll just keep circling your base. It's going to be annoying. It's a pain. And that's why this mission is so difficult. It's not necessarily after you have troops. It's always when you're building this base. I don't know why sending five Banshees is kind of overkill. Four or five Banshees is kind of overkill, but that's what we're being asked to defend. So it's going to be okay. Forge and Jerome, we want at the front, so make sure that you keep them at the front, because there's going to be hunters, there's going to be a bunch of other people, a bunch of other Covenant units coming up towards the front, and we want to make sure that they're able to handle the damage that's going to be inflicted on them. So they're going to tank the damage is what I'm trying to say here. So as you see here, make sure the Wraith is also over here because its main job, of course, is to tank the damage. But yeah, once you get all these turrets up as well, life is easier. But again, those Banshees, because of their fuel rod, they're ruthless. Yeah, there's not, like, this part of the mission, if you're wanting to fast forward through the video of this, like, beginning part, feel free, because this is kind of what it's going to be like for a little bit, building the base, making sure that we're building our units. I don't want to, like, keep showing you the exact same fight over and over again, but if you want to stay and just, like, see how the base is built, see what I'm building and what I'm doing during that time, feel free. I believe in the description below there's going to be a timestamp to where everything starts to actually heat up. But yeah. During this part, missile launchers, the only real enemies that you're going to be worried about are those Banshees. And of course, getting those heavy supply pads is going to be very, very critical. The strategy for this mission is... I tried doing infantry. Infantry is just really not that good after mission 4. But your main idea, and vehicles are okay, but with the enemies that you're going to be fighting, like for example, a Scarab, you're going to want to make sure that you don't use something as costly as, like, let's say, Scorpions and Wolverines. Like, it's a strategy you can go. I advocate that as a viable strategy. But I also would say to make sure that you're also worried about your mobility. Because, remember, they have to go around the map. And there's 4 bases that you have to clear. We cleared the first one. There's the second one a little bit north. There's one to the east. And then there's one up northwest. So, and you want to make sure you get all those. And we really are trying to get that mobility. And the most mobile unit that I've been able to find is a Hornet. So, we're going to go Hornets on this mission. So, air is very, very fun. Always a good strategy to go, especially if you're just worried about finishing the mission, getting a gold. Like, this is a gold medal run right here. Looks like Alice got shot out of her Wraith. I should have been keeping a better attention on that. Make sure that those units don't go too far away from the spot that we want them to be at. Once we get those Hornets and they're able to actually sit there and defend, life is going to be pretty nice. So actually, I think I wanted Alice to get shot out of the Wraith. Because she's going to be taking command of the Scarab that we're going to be getting in a few moments. Ready. You got it. Or is Jerome going to? I forget. Regardless, either or. Just all that matters is that we hijack a Scarab. And that's actually one of the achievements for this game. Hijack that Scarab. So, of course, we're going to upgrade the Hornets, their max upgrades. We're going to get Chaff Pods and Wingmen. And just need to save up the money now. Those Banshee attacks are ruthless on Legendary difficulty, though. Like, look at that. Absolutely obliterating the base. Even with the missile launchers. Again, don't be bashful with that heal and repair. You're going to need it a lot in this mission. And you're also going to need to rebuild your turrets quite a bit, too. Local units. Let's see here. It looks like 2 turrets got shot down. We're going to build the front one first. That way we have a little bit more reinforcement when they go around. If you want to, you can also get a field armory and on your first base, like take away one of those heavy supply pads if you want, and you can upgrade your medium turret. I would only recommend getting a medium turret first because you don't want to take forever doing this mission. I tried to find a fast, a very quick and efficient way to do this mission, and this is by far the best I've ever done on this mission. So, making sure we're taking down those Banshees. What the heck is going on? Alright, so one thing I forgot to mention is also the skull and the black box. We're going to get both of those, as we have in pretty much every other mission. The skull for this mission is to kill those 10 bomber forms to unlock the skull, of course. And then where we were at the beginning is where we picked up Anders and all that. That's where the skull is. The skull is going to be where a bunch of Flood are. It's not fun to get the skull either. This mission is just overall one of my least favorites because of how tedious and like it's difficult at the beginning, but after that it's just tedious because all you're doing is you're like, okay, all right, now I have to go kill this base, and then I have to go kill this other base to go kill this base, and of course it's boss battle base where you get to deal with the scarab. It's always this mission is just. And this also is the only mission that actually gives me a lot of trouble sometimes. But it's because of these stupid Banshees. That's why I'm focusing on getting that strategy down, is making sure that you focus down those Banshees. That's the number one thing. Because you can lose, if you don't, if you're not careful, you can lose you can lose by just losing all your forces and your base right here. And this first part, this is all annoying. Getting those Hornets. So, as you saw there, we're using the Pelican, dropping off Jerome. And I believe the reason why we drop off Jerome is because of his range. So, those tentacles, because they can hit Alice from that distance. They can't hit Jerome from that distance. So, he's fine. The only thing that you want to be careful of is... the only thing you want to be extremely careful of is making sure that your... that his Spartan laser is not hitting the Scarab, because if it does damage the Scarab, and it takes a lot of time to heal the Scarab. So make sure that when he's hitting the those tentacles, that he's in an that his angle is okay, if that makes sense. That way he's not doing double damage to the Scarab. And infected grunts just sitting there being a pain. Banshees. When you have all those Hornets, I should probably move the Hornets up, but it's not going to be a problem much longer. Not to mention, once we get the Scarab, that's when we start actually doing a bunch of stuff. Like, we're going to go... the first thing we do is we actually use that Scarab to clear out base number 2, because there's so much crap that they don't worry about at base number 2. That's why we grab the Scarab from behind. We don't want to clear base number 2 with our Hornets, because we're going to lose a lot of Hornets on that suicide run. But if we use the Scarab, all we have to do is mop up all the stragglers. And with the Hornets, we actually have a bunch of other stuff that we're going to be doing too. The Hornets that you're going to be taking over there, you're going to be clearing out the summits on the very far right, and then you're actually going to be clearing base number 3 shortly after. You can actually help out Jerome if you wanted to with these Hornets, but I really don't like dealing with those Banshees. And I think every time you destroy one of those summits, the time between attacks on those Banshee strafing runs, they kind of change just a tiny bit. I'm not 100% sure on that, don't quote me. Checking up on that. Then we can send our Hornets back to base. Checking up on Mr. Jerome. And this is what I'm talking about. Don't do that, because you're going to hurt your Scarab. But Scarab went perfectly fine. All right, so with the Scarab, after we rebuild this turret, and we're making a lot of money now. This is the part where money's not even a problem anymore. Local units. All right, so with your scarab, you're going to march right up to the bridge, and you're just going to sit there and snipe that base. The Hornets will sit right behind him, making sure that nobody is targeting him. We do not want the scarab to die. Lose the scarab, it's going to be so much more difficult to do this mission. Trust me. Naturally clear out those turrets. Once you clear the turrets, the Hornets can actually contribute. We're going to lose that turret right there. Also, whenever you get whenever you get a new base, so like for an example, when we destroy that base and build on it, you're actually going to want to build whatever you want. You don't have to build what I build on there. Just build like a field armory, barracks, whatever you want. It doesn't matter. The only thing that I would say is that stick with the strategy of Hornets. And build like one air pad per base. That way you have a little bit more unit producing structures. That way you can, if you lose a bit of Hornets, you can get them back faster and you don't take too much time having to wait. Now with the Hornets, their main function is just to mop up the rest. Because we do need to build on those empty plots. And we're going to micro them away because they're taking a little too much damage. Looks like the jackals are targeting the scarab, which is nice. Oh, Wraith, how you doing? Making sure the scarab is taking... Scarab's taking, like, no damage at all. It's kind of cool. It's really awesome because the scarab doesn't count against your unit cap. So you can just, like, keep him doing his thing. So long as you keep the scarab, like... Oh, when those elite honor guards drop down, that's why we also have the Hornets. Once you drop the elite honor guards coming in, you want to keep the scarab away. Because, yeah, elite honor guards look like they're non-threatening to a scarab, but they actually knock out a lot of the health. And it's not a... And it's just easier to not have the scarab die. My entire strategy is on the scarab here. And look how long it's taken this to kill that elite honor guard. Hunters, of course, you're another main threat that you want to be worrying about when you see. Your scarab is very, very important. Don't lose it. Now your scarab, all you're going to do with it is mop up the rest of everybody else. If they get a little too close, feel free to send in the cavalry, your Hornets, or just micro them away. You don't have to actually use any of the Hornets if you don't want to. I use them because it helps clear out the rest of the enemies faster. But the main reason why you can build one Hornet, send one of your Spartans over there if you want to, and you can just do this entire mission with a super scarab. I don't recommend that. Hornets have a purpose in life, and they're really, really fun, and I'm very much a fan of the Hornet. So use it. But you don't have to. You can win this. You can beat this mission with just the scarab once you have it. Scarab is, as you saw there, like a bunch of those elite honor guards just wrecked this the scarab's health. Okay, bomber forms, whenever you see those, make sure you clear it out. Knock out this Wraith, make sure this area is nice and safe. So until your base is set up to be able to defend on its own, do not leave it. You can send the scarab to go clear out more area if you want to, but keep your Hornets nearby. Because there's still a bunch of enemies that can come by. For an example, the Covenant, they can send an attack. Once you have more than one base, the Covenant actually don't care where they send those the Banshees. They'll just send it to whatever one they want. They'll send it to they'll send it to base 1, they'll send it to base 2, base 3, they don't care. There's actually not even a specific order that you want to take out these bases. If you want to go for base 4 and fight the Scarab there, feel free. If you want to start at base number 3 where we found the Scarab, start with that. But I just started in the progression of how they kind of wanted you to go about doing this. Now, Scarab versus Hunters, that's not a good combination. Look how much health that they took down the Scarab, just those two, just all those Hunters. And those turrets aren't making it any easier. So, yeah, we have heal and repair ready for that. We're going to probably need to use that a few times on the Scarab, that way it doesn't get destroyed. Since we have that turret, we can actually leave the base alone now. Going to use heal and repair, make sure that our Scarab doesn't get destroyed, because that make me very sad. Okay, Scarab plus those Hornets. The cool thing is that once we get that second base going, we can get some field upgrades. Field upgrades like reinforcements, medium turret, heavy turret, not heavy turret, but large turret. Stuff like that, which is going to make this much easier as well. Lost a Hornet. Gonna get another Hornet really fast. Hey, don't get adrenaline, no point in it. Get medium turret, reserves, carpet bomb, and reinforcements. That's all you really need. Just gonna keep healing, repairing that, that Scarab until it's useful. Being careful over here at the base, making sure that nothing's getting too intense. Infection forms just got murked. Checking out. Okay, so cool thing is that the Scarab, not the Scarab, but this base is kind of undefended. Those Jackals aren't going to do much to the Hornets. So kind of just sit in the back of the Covenant base and just kind of... just take, just chip away at that shield. Eventually, that base will be, it won't be a problem. I don't know why they are building Jackals when I have a bunch of Hornets. Usually, they try to respawn with whatever you have, like those Hunters. And targeting down the shield generator for no reason. Oh, heal and repair is nice. Take out those infection forms. Remember, at 50% of the health on a base, they send a ton of... what are they called? They send a ton of reinforcements, mostly elite honor guards. And you're going to want to make sure that you focus them down. Looks like they don't even want to move, though. I think they're focused on... oh, look at that. They actually started targeting it down. We also destroyed the base, too, so we're good. Elite Honor Guard still chipping away a little bit at that Scarab, but looks like Scarab's going to... I mean, Scarab wins the fight most of the time, but... or pretty much every time, but I don't like losing health on that Scarab. Coming over to base number 2, making sure we can upgrade anything else. Enemy engagement. Local units. You got it.
local units.
Too easy.
Supply pad.
Alright.
Carpet bomb. Improve.
Bomb reforms. So eventually, at a certain point, the Covenant stopped being a threat, and you're just going to sit there and be worried about the Flood. The black box is near base number 3. Once base number 3 is built, get those turrets up ASAP. If you want to, you can go over to the right here where the Hornets are at, and you can destroy that little Flood vent where the Flood spawn out of. Or you can... Like, as I said, here comes another attack by the Banshees. Now they're going to send forces at both bases, or all three. And make sure that all these Banshees get destroyed. Get the black box while we're here. Heal and repair the Scarab. Personally, I don't like going up to base number 4 until I have all my forces heal and repaired. Heal and or repaired. But up to you. You can sit here and take your time. But I think the reason why I waited also is because we don't have the skull yet. Otherwise, you can actually just go in with your forces right now and destroy the final base. Before you send the Scarab up, also, you're going to want to clear out the turrets up at the top here. Looks like we lost a Hornet. Get a Hornet over there. Get a large carpet bomb. That bomb reform is scary. Almost have healing repair. One Hornet versus a turret. That's not a very smart idea.
Air pad complete. Local units.
On my way. On my way.
Making sure that we can't do anything else.
Turret complete.
Hornet here.
Yeah, they're still sending a bunch of stuff. Like,
local units.
At a certain point, like...
All units.
Sorry. At this point, we have everything we need to start an attack on... the final Covenant base, but what we're going to do is we're going to quickly go to the we're going to quickly go over to the top left where the Flood are, and we're going to make sure that the that when the skull spawns, we're able to actually grab it as soon as possible, because after that we're going to finish the mission. And yeah, that's pretty much it. All right, this fight is really, really difficult. I just kind of suicide ran in. I didn't really care. Setting global rally point to go over there. That's 8 bomber forms. Target down Flood swarms first, by the way. The infection forms can't get you. Making sure that we're getting more reinforcements. Bomber form again. Number 10, bomber form soon.
On my way.
Turret complete.
And then once that bomber form is destroyed, we can grab the skull that spawns in. And hooray, we have the skull in the black box, all aboard the pain train, and the pain train's going to stop at Covenant base number 4.
Enemy
engaged. Super carpet bomb. Probably not the smartest idea to put the Scarab in the pathing of those Banshees, but it's okay. That's funny. It's all good. Plenty of Scarab. We have plenty. It's all good. Whatever. Hornets are going to go up here to the... So there's still turrets lining this ridge, so you want to make sure you destroy those. Take down the summit right here. Put a global rally point in the bottom left corner there. It looks like they didn't even upgrade them to anti-air, which would be kind of smart if you're the Covenant, especially where you put them. This is why they lost the war. I guess they had no strategy. We're just going to send the Super Scarab through. The Covenant have their own Super Scarab, but the thing is ours is better because we know how to use it and they don't. And there's a Scarab. So it's going to be Super Scarab versus Super Scarab. He's going to be chilling here, getting all healed up. Nice. Field armory is all good. Alright, once everything's there, moving in on an attack run. Super carpet bomb, knock out everything. Look how much damage. This is why we get all those upgrades. But, problem. That many Elite Honor Guards is really going to knock out our Scarab. And for some reason, the Scarab is still kicking. And when we demolish that Scarab, by the way. The Hornets are going to start destroying the Covenant base. But we want to make sure that the Scarab doesn't die first. There we go, all units, and then we maneuver our way over. Alright, get some more Hornets, making sure that we're always rebuilding our lost units. And there you go, awesome. Once you destroy all the summits on the map, the enemies stop attacking you on those Banshee strafing runs. Making sure, knock out those turrets first. Looks like we're gonna be fine. The only thing that I'm gonna suggest here is to make sure that your Scarab isn't as close as mine is right now, because this is how I lost it, I think. The Elite Honor Guards came again, right now at right about halfway point when we were about to destroy the base. And its health is really, really low already. And to get the hunters and everything over here, it's just not a good day. I lose the Scarab, and I think I lose the Spartan too. Get the pun. Kidding. Stupid lore joke. And that Spartan got assassinated. That's not good. Okay. So we lost maybe a grand total of 7 units compared to them, where they lost way more than that. So I would say that we got a good combat efficiency going. That means a good combat score. Good score means high multiplier. And that's good news for us, because we don't want to not get a gold medal. Who needs silver, bronze, or tin medals? I want gold medals. Once we have this base built, it's all good. And that'll be the end of the mission. But as I said, this mission, once you get past the initial difficulty of the of building your base and all that, it's a fairly easy mission. Not easy, but it is a simple mission, and it doesn't take that long to... it does take a little bit, but I mean, you can blast through each of those Covenant bases if you want to. I was just taking my time, but here's the screen. We did it in 37-31, way over part time, within part time. Got that gold medal. I hope this was helpful, guys. If it was, please leave a like, subscribe, and please comment if you have any questions. Again, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time for mission number 14. Thank you.